to you about your time in Iraq. Please, please, please use this opportunity as a chance to talk about yourself. You know, as veterans, we don't want to boast about ourselves. We don't want to say, yeah, you know, I've been there, I've done that. Yeah. But it actually helps with the unit because it'll help with your credibility. It'll help with their trust for you. It'll show the soldiers that you know what you're talking about. So we really appreciate when the volunteer does that.
To the Anbar province in Ramadi. It was a hard tour. My friend Alex passed away by sniper fire, and the next day my good soldier Henry passed away the next day by a mortar round. What had happened was a car had sped up past the checkpoint and there was an explosion. And so I told my guys to lay low and I was gonna go out and look at the area because I didn't want nothing bad to happen to them. And Henry, not letting me go by myself, decided to come with me. But I didn't know he was coming behind me. And the next thing I heard was the sound of just the and it hit him. I told my guys to leave because if this thing blew, I didn't want them to go. I saw that he was still alive and I stayed with him because if he wasn't gonna let me go alone, I wasn't gonna let him go alone either. He only lasted for a minute, but it still haunts me. His just looking at him, he looking at me. Because I kept a lot of stuff in. Because absolutely. With any soldier, I kept a lot of things for like 10 years and it erupted. To me, getting stuff out works wonders. It started in 2009. It got to the point where I started recognizing that I needed help, but I didn't want to leave the military. I wanted to seek medical attention where I wanted to see a therapist, but I didn't want what happened. I was med boarded out because of PTSD, traumatic brain injury, and other stuff, my lower back.
Definitely go to the hospital.
I'm not hateful towards the army or nothing like that. It's just, ever since I got out, it was difficult.
So interestingly enough, Kevin was actually in the military before me. One of the reasons why I joined the military was because of his time in the service. However, he got out of the military and he went through some really hard times, maybe didn't make the best of decisions across that path that he was on. And when I left the military, he was in a really terrible state.
I'm introducing Lynn Louder and Kevin Cruz today, both infantry guys. I was an infantry guy myself as well, so we've been in your shoes. We know what you're going through.
Kevin has trouble remembering things. I think that has a lot to do with the TBI. But as far as PTSD, I know he struggled with it for a long time at home, and it actually hurt his marriage. It probably has something to do with him not being able to sometimes sustain a job. He would borrow money from me. He was living out of his car. He was moving in with family. And it's tough because that's someone that I really care about. That's someone that I know shouldn't be where he's at. I mean, he has 3 combat deployments, a Purple Heart. He was in Iraq during the invasion. This is someone who has tons of leadership training. This is someone who has tons of military experience, who now is going through some of the hardest times of his life, probably.
It was a combination of a lot of things. I had gone up to the mountains and it was a low point in my life. I was about to take the step to jump because there's a lot of mountains, a lot of hills. And again, my little girl's the one to stop me. That one memory that I made her promise that daddy's gonna come back. in my head. Kept telling me, I'm such a hypocrite. You made it back, and now you're gonna end it. There's always a way. There's always a solution.
How's it going, guys? My name is Kevin Cruz. Army veteran over 10 years. I've been through a lot of experiences that I can relate to most of you guys. I'm happy to volunteer here with you guys and try to help you guys out if you're having issues with either employment or family issues.
What we do is we train veterans who have been in the service. We train them as volunteers, and then we actually place them in National Guard units. Most of the time, the soldiers in those units will come up to our volunteers and ask them for help directly. Sometimes they won't. Sometimes it's just through their phone number, through their email, or through someone in the unit who shared that information with them. And we find them the resource, we connect the dots for them.
Have any problems, just shoot me an email or text or anything like that, okay?
One of the symptoms from someone who's suffering through something is to want to help. So he wanted to help. He wanted to volunteer with us for a long time. And I originally had some reservations, but to be honest, he's an upstanding individual. He's extremely smart. He's enrolled in college. So we brought him on as a volunteer. He applied a while back. We did the training for him, and we thought he'd be a great fit specifically with an infantry unit.
I've lost a soldier through suicide. I didn't recognize the signs. I've been through lost a soldier already in combat. Lost a wife. I've been going through relationship problems. I've been through losing the kids. I know how these factors can play in your life. The employment, lost a job, having had a hard time finding a job, having a hard time staying motivated. So I can be a resource. I want them to use me. We can help each other out.